Why, hello there, everybody. How you doing today? It's me again and again. I am here to encourage you. I am here to inspire you. I am here to educate you. I am here to motivate you. I am here to inform you. I am here to build you up. I am here to lift you up. I am here to bring and give you peace. I am here to bring and give you hope, because I'm here to bring, give, and tell you the truth. The truth. That's what the enemy, that's what the devil hates the most. The truth is what liars fear. The truth is what the enemy and liars are trying to neglect. They're just trying to get rid of it. They are so afraid of it that they make you, me, we. Or should I say they try to make you, me, we, afraid to speak the truth, afraid to think the truth, afraid to live in truth. And that's the truth. Think about that for a minute. The enemy's goal is to get you to live a lie. Well, here's the truth, folks. The truth is you, me, we are unique, one-of-a-kind individuals that are going to live for eternity. We are going to exist for all eternity. No ifs, ands, or buts about it. You, me, we are eternal beings. And the only thing that you, me, we each are going to have to be held accountable for or give an account of are our, yours, mine, ours, individual action. Plain and simple. That's the bottom line. Whoever lies has to give an account for lying. Whoever tells the truth is rewarded for telling the truth. That's what it comes down to. And if you are fearful of telling the truth, of speaking truth, of living truth, then that tells me you are being oppressed. You are being attacked, because that's not coming from Almighty God. Almighty God is light. Almighty God wants you free to freely choose whether or not you want to lie or tell the truth. He doesn't force or make anybody do anything. The enemy wants to come in and convinces everybody that that everybody's a liar. Because that's what you hear. Oh, everybody lies. Little white lies. Yeah. Okay. If you want to say that, if you want to claim to say be a liar, well, that's your business, not me. So, and that's what happens, is they come in and they start casting doubt. You know, a couple of days ago, earlier this week, Sheriff Clark had a video, and he says one of the greatest, most horrendous things to overcome is to be labeled or accused of being either a racist, a child molester, or something of that sort. He listed three of them, and he's absolutely right, because all of those things, or somebody that's racist, they're sexist. They're a very bad person. Because, again, in today's society that we live in, everybody lumps everybody into one big pile. And because we fear that, we don't stand up for those who are falsely accused of it. Well, let's just see if it's real or not. What does it matter? Famous line. At this point, what does it matter? You know, I actually had Ken Amaro tell me that. I got the email. What does this matter? Caught. What it matters is it scares you all. And it waters down truth. Here are the facts, folks. Not everybody that has a uniform on with a badge is a good guy. Just like they're not all bad guys. But because the good guys won't remove their own bad guys. Let's just stick with law enforcement for a second. Law enforcement officers are no different than you, me, we. They think just like us. They talk just like us. They do the very same thing. They go to sleep in a bed. They get thirsty. They get hungry. And yes, they go to the bathroom. And yes, they as well are capable of having bad thoughts and doing bad things. We see it all the time. A police officer is pulled over for drunk driving while he's driving a squad car with a bottle of vodka in the front seat. Happened right here in Jacksonville. But you see, we don't want to focus on that because, oh, no. Because then that's discrediting. No, that's discrediting that individual, not the entire institution. Folks, we are individuals. Individuals. No one defines your actions. No one has to explain why you did what you did. Only you have to explain why you did what you did. No one can force you to think and focus on any thought you choose. You want an out. I'm not going to give you the out. Because the truth is, there is no out. When you get to the end of the road, you are going to be held accountable for everything that you did. That's all I have to make sure that you understand. If you understand that, then I've done my job. I've done my job. Now, if you come and ask me, well, how can I make sure that I don't go to hell? Then, again, it's not my job to make sure that you do it. It's just my job to tell you how to do it. That's the problem. The church has stopped telling people the godly, righteous, holy way to live. No. And the reason why they stopped doing it is because a few have pulled out a bunch of rule books and said, you have to do this. That's called religion. I don't have a religion. I have a relationship. Yes, I talk to God every day. All the time. Every day. Doesn't make me better than anybody. But it does make me a better human being. Because I talk to him, and then I actually apply what he tells me to do. Doesn't make me a better person. It doesn't make me more important than anybody else. It just makes me a better me. That's all it does. Because, hey, hello, I'm the only one I'm worried about. My mom can say something stupid to me. My brother can say something stupid to me that I do not agree with, that I know is incorrect. But guess what? They're the ones that are going to have to live with the consequences of saying and thinking that way. They are, not me. So, what happens? How does the enemy work? Here's how the enemy works. They come in, and first thing that they have to brainwash you and convince you of is that others can tell you what is right and wrong. The only one that can tell you what is right and wrong for you is you. And here's how the enemy twists it. Is there a definite godly way to do things? Yes. What happens if you don't do the godly thing? Well, you end up in hell, is what happens. But what happens if you've been doing bad things and then all of a sudden you ask for forgiveness? Then how much good things do you have to do? You don't have to do any more good things. You will begin start doing good things once you know Almighty God, once you have a relationship with Almighty God. There is no making up for something. The blood of Jesus covers everybody's sins. All sins. The Word of God is clear. The Word of God is true. It says that He will take your sin and cast it as far as the east is from the west. Throws it into the sea of forgetfulness. Into the sea of forgetfulness. So what man has done is man has come up with his own little checkbook lists called religions and says, if you dress a certain way, if you walk a certain way, if you talk a certain way, if your hair is a certain length, if you have a certain amount of money, hello, then you're godly. And then the devil raises up nice, what appear to be morally sound people. And then everybody says, well, they're Christian because they're nice. They've got to be a Christian. Look, God's blessing them because look at how much money they have. And in comes the perversion. I don't get to decide. Me, do not get to decide how anyone else is gets to live, whether or not it is right for them or anyone to live that way. The only individual that I get to do that to is me, period. Because I know that truth, I am not going to allow anyone to come tell me, define who I am. Keep it simple, stupid. I tell myself that every day. Keep it simple, stupid. If you don't like eating something, if something just isn't that's not your palate. It's just not something you like. Anything. Let's say some people don't like ice cream. Don't know why I love ice cream. But if you don't like ice cream, you know what? You're not going to eat ice cream. Doesn't make you a bad, immoral person. Just like someone who eats ice cream does not make them a good, moral person. Now, there are a set of rules and guidelines. There are a set of the morality standard has been set, but it's not set by man, it's set by Almighty God. Plain and simple. You freely choose whether or not you want to meet that standard or you don't want to meet that standard. And the consequences of not meeting that standard is, well, eternal hell. Okay? Plain and simple. You can live however you want to live. But if it is in direct opposition, if it is the exact opposite of the standard of Almighty God, Almighty God is the one that decides where in the world you're going to spend eternity. And there is no bribing Almighty God. So, what we have here today is this. We have had too many people, too many fakes and frauds, who are, when you look at them, oh man, they're really nice, clean-cut people. Mm-hmm. But then when you get around them, suddenly they don't even mention Almighty God. Just morals. God's not about morality. Well, God is about morality, but that's not what he's about. When you can't fake morality. You either have morality or you don't. You a morally sound person, a godly person. See, that's what the world does. The world just says, well, you just have to be moral. And then that's watering down godliness. That's watering down holiness. And there's only one way to be holy. Man all by himself cannot be holy. He must have Almighty God's assistance. Almighty God deems what's holy and what's not holy. Anyone with Jesus living in their heart is a holy person. So says Almighty God, because hello, that's God in your heart. So a person with God in their heart is not going to go to for an hour a week, go to a church or go to a building that they call a church and sit there and say, okay, I did my time. Now we're going to go out. We're going to cuss. We're going to fuss. We're going to lie. We're going to tear down. We're going to attack. All of this stuff that I've been telling you is going on in the church. Simply because we have decided, have given up our individuality. Thank you, I got it out. Individuality. And accepted the herd mentality. The tribal mentality. As soon as you do that, then what happens? You're a slave. You're cattle. You're a drone. And then somebody can come and tell you when you're right and when you're wrong. Somebody can tell you what your limits are and what your faults are. Someone can come in and tell you what you can and cannot do because you allow it. Because, hey, I'm nothing more than just one of the tribe. No, you are a unique, one-of-a-kind individual that Almighty God wants to know. He wants a relationship with you. That's what this whole election process has been about, folks. These people have been in control because we have allowed them to be in control. They're still in denial. You see, what happens is the media is the mouthpiece. The media is supposed to be the watchdog. They're the ones supposed to be the ones looking for corruption. Instead, they are the ones promoting it and covering it up. And hey, the politicians aren't off the hook either, because they're the ones that are getting their pockets stuffed. You are nothing but a meal ticket to these people, folks. Oh, it's... We need justice. We need justice. Justice comes from Almighty God. That's it. Man is not going to give you justice. A godly man will give you justice. But an unrighteous, they don't know justice. You are nothing. If there's nothing in it for them, then you are nothing. That's what our legal system is coming down to, folks. And they have their, once they get there, see, here's how it works. They get their hooks in somebody. And they say, okay, now, we're going to move you up the ladder. Okay? But if you ever do anything, we're going to take you out because we got this in the closet waiting for you. So that person allows themselves to be manipulated simply because they're getting something out of the deal too. They're getting a position. They're moving up through. But most importantly, they're not paying for the crimes that they've been committing. They're covering up for themselves. Hello, Jacksonville. Hello, Fourth Circuit County Court System. Hello, Duval, Jacksonville Sheriff's Office. Then all of a sudden, somebody like me comes around that they can't have any hooks in. They can't get any hooks in because I'm not a criminal. So what's happening is all of these fakes and frauds are being exposed. They are being exposed, and it's happening right in front of you. I've been saying it from the get-go. I'm going to say it again. This is not happening to you. It's happening for you. And the reason why it's happening for you is to show you, hello, these people, the people that it's happening to, they have all taken an oath to Almighty God. They have violated that oath. They have taken an oath to Almighty God to operate under Almighty God's legal authority structure, by Almighty God's jurisdictional structure, and by Almighty God's legal structure, and they have violated all of them. We have severe problems in this country. And they have deliberately done it, and their whole goal was what? Money. Well, they've just been exposed. Almighty God moved. This election was a move of Almighty God. And it's time for what he's doing, what's going to happen. Again, I'm telling you, you're going to be surprised at who is going to be coming out wearing orange and in handcuffs. And it's happening right there where you are. If you don't believe me, watch one local news channel, one news broadcast. Watch another one, a second news broadcast. However many news channels you have. See, here in Jacksonville, we're getting ripped off here in Jacksonville. There's 5 different stations, but there's only 3 different newscasts because of this duopoly stuff. Because, hello, the media owns everything. And the independent isn't even really an independent because it's owned by a corporate conglomerate. Folks, it's their mouthpiece. But you go watch one newscast. And what you're gonna find, just do rotate them every day. And what you're gonna find is they're all saying the same thing. They all talk about the same thing. How exactly is that news? And they're all so nice, and they all want your opinion. They all want to know everybody's opinion is right, except the ones that are really telling the truth. Well, that's a lie. That's fake. Hello? Hello? So, that's your hook. And if you go against them, then they will pour down rain on you. Well, guess what? I'm going against them. But they don't come pour down rain on me because I've got nothing to hide. I'm not doing anything wrong. If they were to come out, if the newspaper, who I haven't gone to because Almighty God hasn't told me to go to them, but if the newspaper or any of the television stations were to come do a story on me, then that would be exposing their buddies, their partners in crime, which is the government. You see, this is what they do. They say, look, the news media people, all they want to do is be famous. Hey, I'm important. I'm somebody because, hey, I'm on this little box. I'm on TV. So we're going to make us really important. TV is really important. No, TV really isn't important. TV is just entertainment. And especially the stuff that you all are calling news isn't news. You're giving me a bunch of disinformation. You're giving me nothing but a bunch of lies. The only thing that you're telling me, us, is what you want us to believe. What you want us to believe is real. And this past election has just exposed you all. And no, it's not going away. It's not going away. We are not forgetting about it. Because you all can't forget about it because your feelings got hurt. Because for the last 16, 18 months, you all have been saying, Hillary Clinton's going to be the next president. Oh, she's not the next president. That means you all lied. Newsweek had a front page cover. They put out over 175,000 copies of Hillary Clinton, Madam President. Woo, let's go pull them back out. How did they do that? How did they know that? Or should I say, why did they believe that? Because it was rigged. You can't rig Almighty God. This is a move of God, folks. This is happening for you, not to you. This is, again, God's giving you grace. These people have taken an oath. News media takes an oath to tell the truth. They've been lying to you. Turn them off. They're fakes, they're frauds. And real media is stepping up and calling these people out at their own risk. At their own risk. Because they know they can get fired. But you know what? A real journalist tells the truth. Doesn't make excuses. A real law enforcement officer enforces the law. And that's what you're seeing now. There's real law enforcement here. But the bullies are threatening you, my brothers and my sisters. They're threatening you. You real law enforcement officers. They are a threat to you. And you know it. How much of it are you going to take? I'm standing for you. Because I want these fakes and frauds around. I don't want any criminal to get off. And that's what these fakes and frauds do. They water down. They are criminals who are operating. They're the worst kind of criminals. We've heard judges say it multiple times. You're a worst kind of criminal. You're a criminal with a daggum badge. Time for you all. It's time to drain the swamp. It's time to clean the house. It's time for the law to be applied. Just saying.